Hi, I'm Jerry Harvey, and I'm here today to introduce you to the Pearl Processor. The Pearl Processor is a micro speaker management system designed for in-ear monitors. Pearl Processing provides unparalleled control to shape and optimize the audio of an in-ear monitor. It allows us to control the gain, the phase, the time, and equalization of each of the three speakers, low, mid, and high, in an in-ear monitor. The Pearl operates at 96K currently, with future upgrades via firmware to 192K resolution. The other cool thing about the Pearl is it's very, very fast. It has a very low latency, 0.62 of a millisecond latency. You ask, why is that important? Because anything over 5 milliseconds, if you're a performer, is almost impossible to perform to. And how do we achieve such low latency? We use ACPX, which stands for Actively Controlled Passive Crossover. So basically, we keep the passive crossover inside the earpiece, and we use a three-way processor to sweeten the crossover slopes, the equalization, and the time of the in-ear monitor without doing a low pass, because when you introduce low pass equals removing the high frequencies from a speaker. You end up increasing the delay, the latency, depending on where that high frequency low pass is located. Say it's at 100 hertz, it's probably 15 milliseconds of latency, and that's impossible for a musician to perform to. Fine for audiophiles or anyone else, but if you're a musician performing to it, and we design most of our products to be able to be used by an audiophile and a musician, it's impossible. So we had to make sure we had a super low latency. Because you have to think that when you combine that with a digital console, which is probably a 1.5 milliseconds, and another millisecond for the in-ear monitor system, we can't be above 5 milliseconds, so we had to be below 1 millisecond for the latency. All right, so here we are at the test, at my little test rig. I've got my Pearl software here. It's called the Pearl GUI. And then I have my test set up here that's the phase and the frequency response. And what I have on the tester right now is a prototype of the earpiece we'll be shipping with the Pearl. It's a tribrid. It's a dual dynamic 5 millimeters, dual balanced armature, and quad electrostatic. So we get way out past 20K on this, but I can only measure to 20. So here we go. I'm gonna show you this. This is actually the Pearl software. And on this opening screen here, you have input left and right, you have phase, mute, and gain. And then you have the same thing for the low bands, the mid bands, and the highs. This is input, and these are the outputs. Low amplifier, mid amplifier, high amplifier. So then we're gonna go into the low band. So if you'll notice here that on left and right, we have two bands of parametric, our shelf, and we have high pass, low pass, and delay between components. I can click this and gang it together, and I can click this and gang it together. So, but we're gonna ungang them for now. Over here, we also have the same thing was on the front page, the output faders, phase, and mute. On the mid, same exact features, high pass, low pass, time between components, and then we have four bands of equalization on this. And then when we go to the highs, because of the resonant peaks, we need more bands of equalization to make it perfect. We have a high pass, and then we have six bands of parametric, so we can dissect the high frequencies, which, like I said, high frequency balance armatures have, and even the electrostatics have a lot more resonant peaks to play with. All right, so here we go. So if you look to the screen over here, right now, the phase is kind of a disaster, and then this is the frequency response on the bottom. You can see right here, there's about 4 dB of bump at 60, 125, it's, you know, 3 dB. We have a little suck out at 1K, a little suck out at 3.19K, resonant peak at 5.16, a big hole between the electrostatic and the balanced armature, and this is the electrostatic kind of dying out here. So let me kind of show you what I've done. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead, I've written a program, and I'm going to show you, we're going to have pretty much perfect phase except for the high pass I have in at the low below of 30 hertz, which is gonna be a little bit out, but otherwise it's gonna be pretty much spot on. And I'm gonna make this with just a click of a button. I've already done the processing, go perfectly flat from 20K out past 20K. Then here we go, boom. All right, now you've seen that the phase curve is flattened out, and from 20 all the way out past, this is 20K here. It's down, I don't know what, 2 dB, but you know I can fix that. So I'm gonna come over here. 19.19690, boom. And I'm gonna go 1/12. So. And then I'm gonna go 2 dB here. So you can see, I can put it pretty much anywhere I want. So now I'm gonna put that back to zeros where we were. And you can see that little guy come down there. So anyway, this is a perfectly tuned earpiece if you want flat. For me, I personally don't like the sound of flat, but I just wanted to demonstrate. If somebody wants flat, I can give you flat. Let me kind of break it down. So I'm gonna shut the high frequency, the electrostatic off. You'll see it drop. That's the electrostatic going away. Then I'm gonna drop the mid out. That's the mid going out. And then this is the low frequency driver. Okay? So the low, and here's the low driver with no equalization. So you can see I've done a little bit of finesse work on this to make it perfectly flat. There it goes. And we're gonna go to the mid. And let me shut off the low. I'll show you what the mid looks like. Mute the low. Turn on the mid. Boom. To come up. That's a processed mid. This is the unprocessed mid. All right. So notice this shape right here. This is where most balanced armatures always have an issue. So I'm using the equalization to fill that hole in, because if you look at the unprocessed electrostatic, I'm gonna shut the mid off and I'm gonna turn on the electrostatic. All right, you see the electrostatic, that's 4 electrostatics. If you had a dual, it would be about 6 dB less than that. So this is the shape of the electrostatic before processing. Now here's with the processing electrostatic. You can see I can flatten it out and I can take it all the way out past 20K, no problem. And then I also have 28/100ths of a millisecond delay between the low and the high. And then I have 21/100ths of a millisecond delay between the low and the mid. So I'm gonna go ahead and unmute this. And then I'm gonna put the processing in. You'll watch it go in a phase curve flatten out. Now I'm gonna add the low driver in. And boom. There you have it. So we have flat phase. We have flat frequency response. Okay, so now here's how quick it is. Once again, I'm going to flat with no processing. I'm going to open up the Pearl Triver demo with the flat. It's processed. You'll see it all go flat again, go into phase. Now I'm going to go to a pseudo Harman curve. I just dialed this up real quick. So I click on that, open that, boom. Now we got a Harman curve if that's what you're into. And then we're going to go to the curve that I would probably listen to, which is this one. I'd like to roll the highs off because otherwise it feels like a meat cleaver coming at you. A little bit of a 2K5 resonant peak to offset the insertion loss. And then I've got a little 60 hertz bump that's about 14 dB tall, but that's personal preference. So you've kind of seen how the GUI software works, and this is how I program everything. And now I'm gonna show you what the Pearl Loader is. We're gonna go over here to the Pearl Loader. This is what it will ship with. We're going to connect it, which is this button. It's connected, version 1.8. I'm gonna open this. All right, now you're gonna see, all we're gonna do is a click of the button goes to that file, Harman curve. You can see instantaneously it changes. Pearl demo, my personal curve. So there you have it. That's what we're up to. More to follow.